Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and yesterday Apple released macOS Big Sur 11.2 to the public. This is available to all macOS Big Sur supported devices and is available now around the world at the same time, so you should see it. Now this update came in at about 3 gigabytes or so, depending on the device you're using. So 2.77 gigabytes as you can see here, and it took a little while to install, but once it's installed, it does have quite a few bug fixes in it and reliability updates. Now let's go ahead and close this, and if we take a look at the build number, you can see here it says 11.2. We'll click on it and it says 20D64. Now this is the same build as if you're a developer or public beta tester and you're using macOS 11.2 RC3. They're the exact same version if you were a developer or beta tester, you just had it early. So there's no need to do anything. You already have it. If you'd like to continue beta testing, continue doing that. If not, remove the beta profile and you'll no longer get the developer updates. Now this update, like I said, contains some fixes, and the first thing has to do with Bluetooth. Bluetooth has been a problem for quite a few people, and you can see I have a lot of different Bluetooth devices, and they've updated Bluetooth reliability, and it should be much better. Since installing this update, I have noticed it is better, especially on M1 devices, so M1 Mac, MacBook Pro, Mac Mini, and MacBook Air, you should see some improvements as far as that goes. So Bluetooth has been updated, which is always nice to see. Now, most of the fixes are things you cannot see visually, but they've been addressed, so let's go over them. And the first one has to do with external displays, specifically on the M1 Mac Mini. So if you're using an HDMI to DVI converter, sometimes you would not be able to see the screen. It would just sort of stay black. Now that's been resolved, so if you're using that converter with an M1, it should work properly. Now, if you're using photos, there was an issue if you were editing Apple Pro RAW files. So maybe you're editing a photo that has RAW on it here, and maybe you make some changes to it, whatever you're doing with it, and you want to adjust it, and then you went to click done. A lot of the time it wouldn't save. Apple has fixed this now so that they save properly. So that's something that's been fixed in this update. So we'll go ahead and close that. And the next thing that they've fixed has to do with iCloud Drive. So if we go into our system preferences and then click on our Apple ID, you can see we have iCloud Drive here. Now, if iCloud Drive was turned on and you're using it normally, and maybe you disable iCloud Drive desktop and document folder options. So maybe you have that in your Finder, you're using them with iCloud, for example. So on the left here, you can see here on the left where maybe you're using desktop in iCloud. If you remove that, sometimes it could turn off iCloud Drive altogether. They've since fixed that and it should no longer do that. So that should be resolved in this update. And then if you're within System Preferences under Security and Privacy, and maybe you wanted to make a change, you click the little lock button here. Sometimes it wouldn't unlock after clicking on it and then putting in your administrator password. If you did that, sometimes it wasn't working properly. Now it should be resolved. And then finally, if we go into Notes, and if I bring up a new note here, when you're using the globe key on a MacBook, for example, to bring up the emoji selector, it wasn't showing up properly for a lot of people. So the globe key will now work properly to bring up emoji and symbols when you press those keys or that key. You can use the same combination on a Mac that doesn't have the globe key as well, Control Command Space to bring this up, and it will now work as intended. Now, as far as changes, that's everything Apple's mentioned as far as bug fixes or physical changes. There doesn't seem to be anything else that they've addressed. I hope they fix things with notifications, for example, but there are a lot of security updates. So if we go into security updates here, this is their website showing the security updates. You can see it says about the security content of macOS Big Sur 11.2. There's also a similar security update for macOS Catalina and Mojave if you don't have Big Sur and you have the latest version of those. And as you can see here, as I scroll down, you'll see it says released February 1st, 2021. And I can link this in the description. This is available to the public. Anyone can see this, but there are a ton of security updates in this update. So as I go down, you'll see Core Text, for example, Crash Reporter. We'll keep going. And there's a ton of different updates. So as I go down, you'll see Image IO, IO Kit, kernel. And for example, in the kernel, it says an application may be able to execute arbitrary code with kernel privileges. This has been fixed. It says a logic issue existed, resulting in memory corruption. This was addressed with improved state management. And then again, a remote attacker may be able to cause a denial of service. A malicious application may be able to elevate privileges. Apple is aware of it. Apple is aware of a report that this issue has been actively exploited. Now, they've fixed all of these issues, and as I scroll down, you'll see there's even more. So everything from messages to screen sharing to WebKit, WebRTC, for example. So a lot of different things that have been updated and secured. That leads me to, should you install macOS 11.2? Well, I would say absolutely at this point, just for the security updates alone, whether you're on Big Sur, Catalina, or Mojave. So those are big updates. Of course, if you were having Bluetooth issues, that would be a reason to install this. And there's not any huge changes, like I said, that you can see physically, but a lot of bug fixes. And there may be even more that they didn't list. So I would definitely recommend installing this update if you haven't already. macOS Big Sur in general has been very stable for me, more so than Catalina, but not for everyone. But for me, it has been on every Mac I've used. So for me, I recommend it. The only issues I have with it really have to do with notifications and the way you actually have to clear those. So for example, if I slide in notifications, you have to click the X, and it's just more of a pain to clear these than it was before. So hopefully they fix this, make it a little bit easier. It's hard to click that X sometimes, but other than that, I recommend installing this. And then many of you wonder what these menus are up here. This is an application called iStat Menu. So it just lets me know what's going on with all the different CPU cores and GPU cores, things like that, and gives me my overall temperature. So a lot of people ask every video what that is. And then this is AirBuddy, which lets me see everything connected to it via Bluetooth and connect more easily. It's just a nice visual representation of what's going on. It is a paid app, but I thought I'd just mention it since a lot of people usually ask. So that's it for macOS 11.2 Big Sur. If you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time. Thank you.